Hello everyone. So my name is Ruchi Agnivanshi and I welcome you all to the discussion of one of the very important topic that I have taken from economic survey, and that is mental health. Before we begin and take up the discussion in detail, let me take you to the year 2022. Year 2022 was an important year when the world and India was recovering from the shocks of COVID-19 pandemic. Then for the first time in the history of budget of India, for the first time the finance minister talks on important topic, and the initiative was launched, and the topic was mental health, and the same topic has been talked for the first time by economic survey 2024. An initiative was launched to tackle with the issues related to mental health. What was the name of the topic? What was the name of the initiative that was taken by the finance minister or launched by the finance minister in the budget? It was National Telemental Health Program 2022. Well, 2 saal lagbhag pure ho chuke hain, complete ho chuke hain 2022 ke budget ke baad, jab for the first time finance minister ne mental health or issues regarding mental health ke bare mein baat ki aur ek initiative launch kiya. Well, 2024 economic survey talks on what is mental health, what are the issues surrounding mental health, and what should be the approach, what should be the steps taken to tackle with the issues related to mental health. So let us take up those things in detail, that what has been talked in economic survey surrounding mental health and mental health issues and what could be done. Well, first of all, you are required to know that this topic is important with respect to what part of the syllabus. So we have GS paper 1 and GS paper 2. In GS paper 1, there is a topic, and the topic's name is Salient Features of Indian Society. Salient Features of Indian Society, Diversity of India. In that, there is an important topic, subtopic, that is of health, and in that subtopic mental health becomes important for exam point of view. And the second GS paper of mains is issues relating to development and management of social sector, services relating to health, education, human resource. This is the subtopic, or we can say topic, in GS paper mains 2. For these two papers of UPSC civil services, this topic, that is mental health and issues surrounding it, becomes important. Let us read in detail and understand that what economic survey has talked about. So first of all, as you can see, economic survey 2023-24 highlights an increase in mental health issues among Indians. So this is evident through the economic survey that there has an increase in the mental health issues among the Indians. So there is a data which has been taken up by economic survey, and the data is from, you know, National Mental Health Survey. And as per this data, it says that according to survey, 10.6% of adults in India suffer from mental disorders. So approximately 11%, you can say approximately 11% of the adults in India, particularly adults in India, suffers from mental health disorder. Mental health disorder. Before that, let's understand what do we mean by mental health. Mental health is a positive concept, and it is meant that it is a state. So mental health is a state of what? Of mental well-being, enabling people to cope with the stresses of life. So it's a state of mental well-being, and it enables us, if you are in that positive mental state, then it enables us to realize your highest potential, highest abilities, learn and work well, and contribute to the development of the community and the society and the nation, world, or either nation or the world, if we talk about at the global level as well. So what is the prevalence of mental health issues? First data, we already know that almost 10 to 11% of the adults are suffering from various issues related to mental health. And while treatment gap for mental disorders ranges between 70 to 92% of for different disorders, then the data is spoken by who? By National Mental Health Survey 2015-2016. Then there are higher rates of mental health issue in urban area. So the people who are residing in urban areas face more, you know, more percentage or higher rate of issues with respect to mental health than the people who are residing in rural areas. This is second observation which has been made by economic survey. Then it says that in 2019, one in every 8 persons, so out of 8, if we say, if we take 8 as the standard number, then one out of eight people globally were living with a mental disorder. WHO, so WHO kya bolta hai? Ki agar hum global level ki baat karein, to one in every 8 person is suffering through mental disorder. So these are some of the data related to health issues with respect to mental health. Well, then further economic survey says that if there are instances of decrease in the productivity due to, you know, poor mental health, what are the other aspects where this particular, you know, if there are any issues related to mental health, what are the more impacts of this? So obviously a person suffering from mental health will not like to, you know, be present in the productive capacity. So there'll be cases of absenteeism. So the person or the student that person will be absent from where? School. Agar hum ek student ki baat kare, to student kya hoga? Student absent rahega. Absenteeism. So first thing is absenteeism. So the student will like to skip the school. Employee will not go to work. Then there will be case of what? Absenteeism. And then there will be decreased productivity. If an employee, if a student is suffering through mental health disorder or mental health issues, then that person's productivity decreases and also increase healthcare cost. When such instances of mental health issue increases, then obviously health jo structure, sector hai, health infrastructure, us pe pressure kya hoga? Bad jayega. And then also it says that what are the reasons because of which mental health instances are getting increased. First of all is poverty, second is stressful living conditions, third is inside financial instability, and also lack of opportunity for upward mobility. So kya hota hai, jab insaan ko ye lagta hai ki bhai mere paas opportunity, abhi main gareeb hu ya abhi I am going through poverty or I am, you know, I do not have much financial or, you know, strength, then that person has a hope. Hope kya hai ki mere paas opportunity hai, I have better education, I have better health, and because of which I'll be able to move upward in my financial status ki baat kare. Jab ye hope bhi khatam ho jata hai to iski wajah se bhi mental health issues bahut zyada rise hote hue dekhe ja rahe hain. Insecurity, insecurity bhi, insecurity in what? Many things. Insecurity in relations, insecurity in terms of, you know, what support you have from your caregivers, parents, friends, and your employer also. Insecurity of losing job, ki aaj to hai mere paas job, kal pata nahi job rahe ki na rahe. So there are many reasons because of which mental health issues are rising in India and as well as in the world. This is, has been talked by economic survey. Then further, so yes, there are few factors. In particular, if we talk about the factors affecting mental health, first of all, relationship issues. Second, financial condition. Third, inability of the parents to understand the emotions of the child. Fourth, inability of the caregiver to be there to understand and talk to the person. Fourth, environmental issues. Environment around the person. Ki bhai, yes, I know that I have somebody who I can go and talk to. Or the environment in my working space is quite conducive that I feel safe, I feel secure in my job. So there are some of the factors that impact mental health, and this has been talked by economic survey. First of all, as we talk, poverty. Second is nuclear family. Ye bhi problem hai ki psychological issue nuclear family hai. Family itni choti hai, ek to sab kaam mein busy hai, theek hai, kaam kar rahe hai, kaam mein busy hai. पैसे कमाने की होड़ में, जीवन के सुविधाओं को ग्रैब या क्रिएट करने की होड़ में लोग ये भूल जा रहे हैं कि ह्यूमन टू ह्यूमन इंटरेक्शन कितना इंपॉर्टेंट है. हस्बैंड इज गोइंग टू वर्क, वाइफ इज गोइंग टू वर्क, पेरेंट्स आ रहे हैं घर में, बच्चों के साथ टाइम स्पेंड करने का टाइम नहीं है, पेरेंट्स के साथ टाइम स्पेंड करने का टाइम नहीं है, बात करने का टाइम नहीं है. तो यूपीएससी में इस साल ही एक पेपर में एक सवाल भी आया था कि जो है, यू नो, दिस इमोशंस, जो बच्चों के साथ चाइल्ड हगिंग हैज बीन रिप्लेस बाय मोबाइल्स वॉचिंग. मोबाइल में बच्चे को मोबाइल दिखा रहे हैं और फीड कर रहे हैं, ठीक है, एक तो ये प्रॉब्लम है कि भाई बहुत ज्यादा इन्वॉल्वमेंट इन सोशल मीडिया बहुत ज्यादा हो गया है, पेरेंट्स से बात नहीं कर रहे, मोबाइल में लगे हुए हैं. सो दीज आर कॉजिंग द गैप्स इन ह्यूमन टू ह्यूमन इंटरेक्शन. और हमें पता भी नहीं होता है कि कब हम इनडायरेक्टली और डायरेक्टली गेट यू नो सफर्ड फ्रॉम सच एक्टिविटीज आर ओवर इंटेलिजेंस इन सोशल मीडिया और इन द फोन्स रादर देन टॉकिंग टू ह्यूमंस, टॉकिंग टू पीपल अराउंड अस. व्हाट द इंपैक्ट, इंपैक्ट क्या है? देयर इज अ रिड्यूस कॉन्सेंट्रेशन अमंग चिल्ड्रन. तो रिड्यूस मेंटल हेल्थ इशू होगा तो कॉन्सेंट्रेशन की प्रॉब्लम्स आएगी. 37% अटेंशन डिक्रीज होता है ड्यू टू द ओवर यूज ऑफ स्मार्टफोन्स इंटरनेट. जैसा मैंने बताया ओवर यूज ऑफ स्मार्टफोन्स इंटरनेट की वजह से क्या होता है, कॉन्सेंट्रेशन लेवल बहुत कम हो जाता है, एबिलिटी टू फोकस ऑन थिंग्स. देन फर्दर राइजिंग हेल्थ केयर कॉस्ट प्लेसेस एन इंक्रीज बर्डन ऑन द पुअर हाउसहोल्ड्स. Also, if the person is suffering, if there is someone in the family, there is someone in the family is suffering from mental health issues, then that person has to be taken to the clinics for various health cares. The cost, obviously, jo out-of-pocket expenditure hai, pressure of financial, jo already financially burdened family thi, maybe aur zyada burden ho jaye. Suggestion to tackle, what are the suggestions that has been talked to tackle mental health issues? First, increase in the number of psychiatrists and psychologists. तो क्या है जो हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर्स हैं, मेंटल हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर्स हैं, फर्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ कांटेक्ट कौन होते हैं? साइकोलॉजिस्ट. तो नंबर ऑफ साइकोलॉजिस्ट शुड इंक्रीज. देन सेकंड कौन होते हैं? साइकेट्रिस्ट. तो नंबर ऑफ साइकेट्रिस्ट केयर गिवर शुड ऑल्सो इंक्रीज. सो देर आर फ्रॉम 0.75 साइकेट्रिस्ट पर लाख पॉपुलेशन इन 2022 टू 3% लाख पॉपुलेशन डब्ल्यूएचओ नॉर्म. तो डब्ल्यूएचओ नॉर्म क्या है? डब्ल्यूएचओ नॉर्म कहता है कि भाई 3% जो ये साइकेट्रिस्ट है पर लाख पॉपुलेशन दैट शुड बी 3. अभी कितना है? 0.75 है. और डब्ल्यूएचओ क्या बोलता है कि 3 साइकेट्रिस्ट शुड बी देयर फॉर पर लाख पॉपुलेशन. दिस इज द स्टैंडर्ड, दिस इज द नॉर्म व्हिच हैज बीन प्रिस्क्राइब्ड बाय डब्ल्यूएचओ. सो फर्स्ट सजेशन इज दिस. सेकंड सजेशन इज एडवोकेटिंग फॉर अ बॉटम अप स्ट्रेटजी इंगेजिंग कम्युनिटीज कॉम्प्रेहेंसिवली. सो बॉटम अप अप्रोच, कम्युनिटी एंगेजमेंट. बॉटम अप्रोच क्या मतलब है? फैमिली मेंबर्स को इन्वॉल्व करिए, ठीक है, कम्युनिटी लेवल पे पार्टिसिपेशन बढ़ाइए. एंड होलिस्टिक अप्रोच. होलिस्टिक अप्रोच क्या है? एनजीओ इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ द एनजीओस, इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, केयर हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर्स स्पेशली साइकेट्रिस्ट एंड साइकोलॉजिस्ट एंड द कम्युनिटी. दे शुड ऑल कम टूगेदर टू प्रोवाइड अ रॉबस्ट इन्वायरमेंट वेयर आर एडल्ट्स, वेयर द यूथ कैन ग्रो विद अ पॉजिटिव मेंटल हेल्थ. So these are some of the suggestions which has been put forth by economic survey. And further, these are some of the suggestions. But what are the initiatives that has already been taken by the government? Let's see that. Telemental health assistance and networking across states. Naam kya hai? Telemanas. First thing. Second is Man Darpan. So Man Darpan has also been one of the initiatives that is taken. Man Darpan. To provide psychosocial support to students during COVID-19 and beyond. And then National Mental Health Program to ensure availability and accessibility of minimum mental health care for all. So, to provide minimum health care facility. Global level pe kya initiative hai? Let's see that. So, at the global level, some of the initiatives are there and these are adoption of PARO declaration. What is PARO declaration? You must remember PARO declaration has been adopted to, as an initiative to care or to provide better health. Kya hai? To provide universal access to people-centered mental health care and services. Second is Mental Health Gap Action Program. So there is a Mental Health Gap Action Program that has been taken by WHO to scale up services for mental, neurological and substance use disorder. So even mental health issue can come up by substance abuse, intoxicants, over dependence on the drugs and intoxicant, etc. Well, these are the some of the things which has been mentioned by economic survey. Now you should think what kind of questions can come in UPSC mains. So you can practice this question based on the discussion which we have, and you can comment on the comment box of this YouTube video. And the question is, mental health is one of the most neglected social issues in India. Comment. So 250 words. Let me ask you, if this question comes in UPSC and you are supposed to write this answer, how will you write? You can write the answer, comment in the comment box of this YouTube video, and I'll definitely provide you feedback. So let's wrap up this discussion. I'll see you in yet another important discussion in the same series. Thank you and tathastu.